Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do a Russian almond shape nail. It's a beautiful shape, but I'm going to show you how to do it with Acrygel. So we have...
Is that normal that I can hear that little nail nails music in my head now?
Can you hear the music?
No, I'm just...
I can hear the little music in my head. So we've got Kim with us today. Her nails are short, a little bit trashed, I would say. But, you know, that's what happens when you're a nail technician, doesn't it?
Yes.
And when you try,
when you start filing your old nails off while you're filing other people's nails,
I know that's a nightmare, isn't it? It's like crazy, right? So what I need to do, place that right at the edge of that nail, and then we're going to measure how wide that is. So I know it comes just over this line and just over this line here. See where my thumb is? And what I'm going to do is create two little cuts. So we're going to have a cut here and a cut here into that sculpting form. I'm going to open the back, just give that a little bit more of a rock, just so it's a little bit of a tighter curl. Place that right at the edge. I'm anchoring it up just a slight amount. Let's have a look at the side view. And I can, so I'm checking that everything's level.
At least I know now, it's not just me though. I always thought I just struggle putting my own forms on.
Mm. And can you see how it's coming up a little bit? So if you look at these lines, you can see that it's raised up. And then we have this little gap here. You see the thickest part of that gap, which is there. That is your hidden apex. And the hidden apex and the visible apex that we see work together. Like a little tag team. So let's just have a look how long that one is. If you haven't seen this nail video, oh my god, you need to watch it. It's a delish. So we're gonna go to, we'll leave a little bit of filing room to 3.5. I've got some gel residue wipe off solution in my little dampen dish. You will need that for your brush. And because this is gonna go in the lamp, I'm actually going to just cut off this excess because it'll struggle to get in the lamp. Okay.
And it's not needed.
It's not needed. We don't need it.
Unless you took your finger surfing. Because you have that bit on the bottom of the surfboard.
Oh yeah. I do like fin. Oh, that was too funny. Now you can do this bit I'm doing without the form on if you want. It's up to you. I can do it with or without. So I've dehydrated with the nail prep dehydrator and I am going to put the base coat on. If you keep the form on, when you actually put the base coat on, it doesn't matter if you go slightly over the edge because it'll just sit on that form and that's absolutely fine. Kind of protects the end of the finger, which is great if you have short nails. Right, put me that in the lamp. So once that's cured, we're going to take Tempting Fate. I love this colour. Love, 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 love it. You will need spatula. And we're going to get quite a bit out because it's going to be a long nail. I might have gone a bit berserk with the amount of product that I've got.
People will be complaining now that you're being wasteful.
I know, they will, won't they?
But you can put that back in the bottle, though, can't you? I've seen you do it before.
You could, I could, but I don't think. I'll just be wasteful.
Just to annoy people.
Yeah.
Why not?
So I'm using the Naio Nails 3D brush. And we're going to stretch this product out. This humongous amount of product. Make sure you have your apex, your visible apex in the back third, and we're going to drop down the sides. For those of you that don't get on with acrylic, if you like, your relationship with acrylic is just terrible. Then Acrygel is going to be your best friend. Because you can put it on, it's not going to move unless you boss it around with your brush. I'm actually just going to chop off a little bit of that. Oh, we had a little movement then. Let's support this form. And it doesn't set. You know, some people use acrylic and they struggle because, you know, it sets up too quick.
I think that's what most people struggle with, isn't it?
Yeah.
They said I can't move it quick enough before it's set.
So you're going to roughly do your shape. I will file it into shape afterwards as well. And it's so easy to file because it's softer than acrylic. Put it in a lot like that before it moves. Now, we can still pinch this product while it's warm. Because it's warm and it actually comes out the lamp. Just going to put that pinching tool on for a second. Right. Now, to help this cool, what we're going to do is we're going to apply some gel residue wipe off solution. And that'll cool the gel and hold it as well. Let's take this sculpting form off. And then, if you look underneath, this is what I want you to look at. See, you can get some gel that may not have cured. See there? I'm going to make sure that you smooth that out, and we're going to cure underneath the nail now.
Never knew that.
Oh.
I'll have to remember that for when I do my
set you will.
Later on.
Yeah.
It must be so weird for you, though, Adam, to know everything about nails, but then to actually, as you sat down, it must have felt so weird, wasn't it? Like to...
To try them.
Yeah. Because in your head, you probably think, yeah, I know it because I've seen it. I know what I'm doing, kind of thing.
I think people who obviously start to do them, they know a little bit about stuff, but I know a ton about it.
Yes.
I know so much. Yeah, it's ridiculous. So people learn as they're doing things, where I sort of had all the information... None of the practical experience.
Yeah. So I must say that I was so looking forward to seeing it because I wanted to see the difference of like how it will be for someone who's actually been training and someone who hasn't. And I actually think you did better than than you should have as such.
it was definitely a humbling experience, but also if I'd had 2 weeks worth of training, that boy would have been dust.
That's me and my husband. We were watching you along the side. We walked past as you guys were recording it.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And then he kept walking back. He was like, she's in there. I can see her. She's in there. They're recording. And that's what we then had a chat about it because he asked if he'd ever done nails or anything before. Yeah. And I explained to him that Chris took a bit too serious what you were saying.
So we're going to file side walls nice and straight. So they're coming out nice and perpendicular to the finger. It's very American. Very American word, that, isn't it?
Is it?
I think it is.
An American word.
I think I just hear people in America say perpendicular.
Really? More... Like on a regular basis? Do people just say to you, hi, see perpendicular?
I don't know what it is.
Like Joey saying, how are you doing? But for you, it's perpendicular.
Yeah.
It's so strange, you know.
So we're going to file that cuticle area nice and smooth, and then we are going to come straight up these sides. So we're quite flat at the sides here, on top of that side, and this side will be quite flat. And then as we come to the top, we are going to join those two sides together by softly contouring and give it a nice round top. Oh,
I love this shape. It's so nice, isn't it?
It's such a stunning shape. It's
just
that
you don't really need to do anything to it, do you? Just the nail itself looks nice.
It does. Okay, we went a bit long. Let's just shorten this a little smidge. And even though this is a different shape, I'm still checking down the barrel and looking at the thickness. And you've seen, I mean, I've got a 240 grit file here. It's so easy to file. Yeah, well, I could take a bulk off with the 80, but the 240 grit file is more than enough just to, you know, refine that shape. It's so easy to file and so easy to create that shape. And as I look down the barrel, I want to see if it's heavier on one side than the other. So by that, I mean, is it slightly thicker on one side? Because we want this curve to be symmetrical all the way through. And the reason that we lifted the form a little bit, we raised it, was so we had more room down this side as well. But we could still have a nice straight side wall. And we're going to use the white block just to smooth. So it's going to smooth those demarcations in the nail. So I'm going to wipe over with Gel Residue Wipe Off solution. Just give that a bit of a dust. Look, it's so beautiful. And how easy was that and quick? And we're just going to top coat it now. We just want everything to be all about the shape. Pop it in the lamp.
That was a quick one.
Yeah.
That was way quicker than I thought it was going to be.
It's because it's Acrygel. It's brilliant.
I have to say though, don't you think the new Naio matte top coat is amazing?
Oh yeah, it's brilliant.
I love it.
Let's finish with some cuticle oil. This is the tea tree cuticle oil. Very soothing for our skin. Look at that. I love the Russian almond because it looks like, you know, like a slightly pointed almond from the top. And then it's got that edge nail look from the side. There you are, guys. That's how to create a Russian almond using Acrygel. So easy. Everything I've used will be listed below in the description box, and I'll see you in the next video. So keep watching. Bye.